Hi all, welcome to the first video in our Tech Edge series. We're excited to get this started. For this first tech deep dive, we've picked a topic that is near and dear to our hearts, and one that we get questions on all the time. How does fanless cooling work? Let's dive in. If I asked you to picture a computer and quickly describe it, what would you describe? Probably a big boxy thing with a bunch of cables running around. All right, maybe we'd go a little bit further and talk to me about the components inside that you knew about. Graphics card, CPU, cooler, fans moving all the air around. All right, so check this out. This is one of our latest fanless PCs, and it may look a bit different than what you pictured, but it's actually pretty much the same. Chances are, if you know how a typical fan computer works, you have a pretty good idea of how a fanless PC stays cool too. So let's stay on that comparison. If you didn't know, in a typical fan PC, there's a large heatsink, or maybe multiple heatsinks, typically strapped to the large hot components, the CPU and the GPU at least. Those heatsinks pull heat away from the components to keep them cool. Components are literally sinking heat into them, that's the name. They're usually bolted or adhered tightly to the hot components with some kind of conductive material between. A paste or a very thin pad, something like that. That improves the heat transfer. The surfaces of the component and the heatsink have tiny imperfections, and the material between helps to fill those and create a more complete and functional thermal connection. There we go. We just described how a fanless PC works. Well, sort of. The outside of this chassis is the heatsink, or heatsinks we were just talking about, and all the parts you'd expect to find in this big boxy computer are also in here. Though they're going to be a little more durable and heat resistant than their counterparts. There's a whole little mountain range of surfaces machined into the inside that matches up with the various parts on the motherboard and in the computer. Hot air rises, so as the heatsink heats up, it'll create a flow of air upwards past the thin surfaces, removing heat. That's why we advise people to install these vertically. A larger area for air movement and heating of the air to happen, and thus increased airflow. And that's what drives cooling of the outside surfaces and the removal of all that heat from the computer. There's a lot of optimization to all the things I described to make this thing really kick butt, but the basic concepts certainly aren't magic. So there you go. It turns out you knew a lot more about this than you thought. You can check out our line of fanless computers on our website and at the links in the video description. If there's something you'd like to know more about or think we should cover here on OnLogic's Tech Edge, leave a comment below or just drop us an email. And be sure to like and subscribe for more technology news and updates. From the team here at OnLogic, thanks for watching.